Thank you for joining us for our Monday-Thursday worship service. All of the Teze pieces will be sung three times, so after the first time, you'll probably be able to join in as well. Any of you who have joined us for the service in other years will probably already know the pieces by heart. The service ends in silence as we contemplate the events of that holy evening Jesus shared with his disciples.
Jesus went, as he did so often, to Mount Olives, and the disciples followed him. When they arrived at the place, he told them to pray that they wouldn't give in to temptation. He went away from them, just a bit to pray that God would remove him from the situation, but then asked, as we so often do, that God's will would be done. An angel appeared to strengthen him, and he prayed so hard that sweat like blood was dripping from his face. When he returned to the disciples, they were, of course, sleeping, so he suggested they too might spend some time in prayer.
Then a crowd showed up with Judas in the lead. He came right up to Jesus to kiss him. The disciples knew what was happening, and one of them took a swing at the chief priest's servant and cut off his right ear. Jesus said, "Leave them alone," and he touched the servant's ear and healed him. Jesus spoke to those who had come, high priests, temple police, religious leaders. Seriously, what is this jumping me with swords and clubs as if I were a dangerous criminal? Day after day, I've been with you in the temple, and you've not so much as lifted a hand against me. But go ahead, do it your way. Because it's a dark night, a dark hour.
Arresting Jesus, they marched him off and took him into the house of the chief priest. Peter followed, but at a safe distance. In the middle of the courtyard, some people had started a fire and were sitting around it, trying to keep warm. One of the serving maids sitting at the fire noticed him, then took a second look and said, "This man was with him." But Peter replied, "I don't even know him." A short time later, someone else noticed him and said, "You're one of them." But Peter denied it. "No, I'm not." The accusations continued, as did Peter's denials. But with the last word hardly off his lips, a rooster crowed. Just then, the master turned and looked at Peter. Peter remembered what the master had said to him. "Before the rooster crows, you will deny me three times." He went out and cried and cried and cried. The men in charge of Jesus began poking fun at him, slapping him around. They put a blindfold on him and taunted him. "Who hit you that time?" They kept heaping insult upon insult upon him.
Together and brought him before their high council. They asked, "Are you the Messiah?" He answered, "If I say yes, you wouldn't believe me. If I asked what you meant by your question, you wouldn't answer me. So here's what I have to say. From here on, the Son of Man takes his place at God's right hand, the place of power. They all said, "So you admit your claim to be the Son of God." "You're the ones who keep saying it," he said. But they had made up their minds. "Why do we need any more evidence? We've all heard him as good as say it himself." Then they all took Jesus to Pilate and began to bring up charges against him. They said, "We found this man undermining our law and order, forbidding taxes to be paid to Caesar, setting himself up as Messiah, king." Pilate asked him, "Is this true, that you're king of the Jews?" "Those are your words, not mine," Jesus replied. Pilate told the high priests and the accompanying crowd, "I find nothing wrong here. He seems harmless to me." But they were determined to prove that he was stirring up unrest among the people with his teaching and disturbing the peace everywhere. When Pilate heard that, he passed the buck to Herod, who was in town for a few days. Herod was delighted when Jesus showed up. He had wanted for a long time to see him. He'd heard so much about him. He hoped to see him do something spectacular. He peppered him with questions. Jesus didn't answer, not one word. But the high priests and religion scholars were right there saying their piece, strident and shrill in their accusations. Mightily offended, Herod turned on Jesus. His soldiers joined in, taunting and jeering. Then they dressed him up in an elaborate king costume and sent him back to Pilate. That day, Herod and Pilate became thick as thieves, always before they had kept their distance.
Thank you.
Pilate called in the high priests, rulers, and the others, and told them that he found no reason to crucify Jesus, and that he was going to set him free after a stern warning. But the crowd went wild because they wanted Barabbas to be set free instead. And so they kept shouting, "Crucify! Crucify him!" Pilate tried a third time, but they kept at it, a shouting mob, demanding that he be crucified. And finally they shouted him down. Pilate caved in and gave them what they wanted. He released the man thrown in prison for rioting and murder and gave them Jesus to do whatever they wanted with him.
Distinguished Lords. One by one, by our words, by our action and inaction, we allow darkness to take hold of our hearts. One by one, in our lives, fear replaces hope. We long to be people of the light, Holy One. We long to stand by your side, listening to the sound of your voice. We long to walk with you even to the cross, but we are frightened, limited by human shortcomings. Walk with us, we pray, through the darkness of our lives, through times of uncertainty, illness, grief, and pain. Stay with us through the night until the morning breaks again. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.